how to study for CFA Level 1 Economics. So I'm sure you're aware that the weight is about 10%. That means we are looking at 100 and out of 120, we're looking at 12 questions in the morning and 12 questions in the afternoon. Now, if I calculate a ratio could be number of pages, let us say, in the curriculum divided by number of questions tested on the exam. Tested on the exams. This ratio will be highest, most probably highest for the economic syllabus at level 1, which means compared to the size of the syllabus that's given, the weight is very less, so which makes the business a little tricky. Now, what CFA Institute did in 2017, they cut down on certain syllabus. However, the new revised curriculum for 2017, it has certain sections which assume that you have certain knowledge in economics. What I mean to say is, there is an assumption that you know some basic stuff, and that's how the syllabus is built. But in my experience, most of the candidates taking CFA Level 1 exam generally do not have significant education in economics. So here is the strategy. If you roughly look at the syllabus, we have a certain prerequisite material here. Now, this is recommended for everyone irrespective what your economics background is. And my simple reason for recommending this is, if you have some gaps in your knowledge with these areas, you're going to struggle with the actual syllabus. Now, this is what you're reading. This is what your syllabus looks like. We have two study sessions, study session 4 and study session 5. These two readings here, which is topics in demand and supply and firms and market structure, this part's part of the macro or managerial economics. So if you're a MBA, you know, grad, or if you've done any, if you've taken any course in economics, and if you've studied micro before, you may find some of the concepts discussed here to be a little bit similar or familiar with. Then this particular reading, this reading, and this reading, these three: aggregate output, prices and economic growth, understanding business cycle, monetary and fiscal policy. These form part of macroeconomics, and these two readings part form of international economics, right? This is roughly your very broad level classification. So the strategy is, when you're trying to approach them, first finish all the prerequisite stuff, and right after that do these two readings, do them in one block. Then once you're done with these, then come on to the macro part and try to follow the sequence. Do the micro first, then do the macro part, then start with these readings and finish them in one interval, as in one session. So it could be one day or a 1 week, or however you schedule your time, but try to finish them and then pick up these two, right? So that's your sequence. Step number one, you do the prerequisite stuff. Step number two, you do these two readings. Then step number three is you do these three, and step number four, you do these two readings here, right? This is in terms of your sequence. Now, how much time do you invest, and what do I really need to do? So this is your summary sheet, and let's have a look at how many hours of videos we're looking at. So that's 16 and a half hours of main material, and about 4.5 hours of question and answer review session. So approximately 21 hours of videos, multiplying it with 1.5, we're looking at about 30 hours, right? So you're going to spend at least 30 hours. So let me bring you back to the main page. So step number one, you're going to spend time on the videos, and you're going to spend at least 30 hours. Now, what I'm giving you here is a fast track strategy. And my thought process is very simple, that we have to be very careful about the cost benefit analysis in terms of how much time you're spending on the particular subject and what results it's going to get you, how many questions will be tested. So this is what you're going to do at minimum. Now, once you are comfortable with this, step number two, jump on to questions. Okay, so which questions are you going to do? You're going to do end of the chapter curriculum questions. and you're going to solve questions in candidate resources section. Candidate resources questions are the questions which are available on the CFA Institute website. Now, once you've done these two set of questions, then allow yourself to make mistakes. Be conservative when you're taking the question. The moment you take a mistake, that is your treasure, because then you're going to go back to that particular section of the video or curriculum and read through why it went wrong, right? To try to fill up the small gaps, and maybe throughout this entire process, keep on taking notes. So either you take notes or you take screenshots, you decide what suits you best. And then a day before the exam, this is what you're going to revise with. So the total recommended time for economics is 40 hours. If you have like really shortage of time, then you can try to watch these videos a little faster and at least do the EOCs. Okay, but again, the thing with economics is spend more time on the questions, get comfortable, you know, try to solve questions, make mistakes, get comfortable with your weak areas. If you learn this way, your learning process would be better rather than just, you know, reading curriculum continuously. This is what I think is a more appropriate way. Now, how do you revise a day before the exam? So I'm going to show you the juice notes here. Just give me a minute. I'm opening the juice notes section here. Right, so you open up your juice notes account, jump on to the economics, get your PDF, read through the PDF carefully. So this is your juice notes PDF. Read through this. Make sure that you read through every detail carefully, because we've kind of tried to jam in all the necessary stuff in very limited space, right? So read through it very, very carefully. And let's say you read this and you're pretty okay with this stuff, you know, so you don't need to revise this. But you come on this topic and you feel you're struggling, then you go to the summary video, which is built as per the topic wise, right? So this is your summary video, which is about 28 minutes. Click on that, read through the whole, go through the video, make sure you're comfortable, and then move on, right? That's your revision strategy. The total time, if you decide to go through all the videos, then we are looking at how much? Approximately 30 minutes. And how many videos here? 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So about 210. So we are looking at about 4 hours, or a little less than that. That's your total revision time required for economics. Again, if you have more questions, I'll be more than happy to answer. Post it in the comments. One small tip before I close the video here. This particular topic offers a lot of quantitative type of question on calculations. Don't miss on those easy ones, right? There is just plug and play type of formulas. Remember them, practice a few of them, and you should be comfortable. Thank you very much. See you in the next video.